Hey everybody, just a reminder that we're still doing the Pain Myth special for Patreon, where if you pledge yearly, you'll get 2 months of advanced access to videos, 4K cat clips, the ability to vote on what videos come next, and you'll help fight the good fight against sketchy sponsors for free over at patreon.com/charlatanwonder. And on top of that, you'll get a special Pain Myth card sent straight to you from the untextured void. So some of you might have noticed that we're well into the month of December, but there's still no cooking segments in the videos yet. Well, fret not. I've saved something extra special for the holiday season. Big soup. What is big soup? Well, once upon a time, I really wanted to make some potato soup. So I looked up some recipes and came across one called Absolutely Ultimate Potato Soup over on All Recipes, which was pretty good once I made it, but I wasn't sure that it was the ultimate soup. So I kept tweaking it and making it more cursed until it required a large stock pot to contain it, and trying to enter it into any sort of diet tracking app will crash said application. Look at that, I got all that context out of the way in about 30 seconds. Take that, crappy food bloggers. So here's what you're gonna need to make yourself one big soup. 8 pounds of taters, 3 pounds of bacon that's not too thick as you gotta make sure it cooks reasonably fast, 3 medium-sized onions, 2 bunches of celery, 1/2 a bulb of garlic, processed however you like it, at least a gallon of chicken broth, 1 pound of butter, 1 quart each of half and half and heavy whipping cream, a bag of flour, which we will be using an indeterminate amount of, a full bunch of parsley if you wanna, or you can just use the dried kind, black pepper, oregano, some thyme, maybe kosher salt to taste at the very end, don't add it during cooking. It's just between the bacon and the broth, this is already gonna come out really salty, and you'll only need the littlest bit in each bowl once it's done. As for tools, go and grab yourself 1 chef's knife, 3 large mixing bowls, 1 cutting board for meat and 1 for veggies, 1 large high-walled saucepan, and then maybe another frying pan to help speed things along, the largest stock pot you can get your hands on, a spatula or wooden mixing spoon, a cooling rack or two, several ramekins or another small heat-resistant container, a sifter of some sort, and an immersion blender towards the end, and lastly, a whole lot of paper towels. You're gonna need them. Alright, buckle up and get right with whatever pyre powers you might or might not have. We're getting into the prep work. First order of business is to take a couple of those bowls and fill them about halfway up with water, open the packets of bacon, and get your saucepans on the stovetop. Bring your big brains, because if we want to get this to work right, we're gonna have to do a bit of multitasking. Cover your cooling rack with some paper towels to soak up excess grease, and then load up both pans with bacon. Once the bacon's in, start peeling and cutting up those taters, immediately depositing them into the water once they're skinless and cut up. Don't worry about the water being too dirty at this stage, as we're going to rinse and change this water for the taters several times before they go into any sort of cooking pot. Now is a time that you're going to want to keep an eye on your bacon while peeling so that you can find a rhythm between your flips. The bacon doesn't have to be super crispy, as it's just going to get rehydrated and cooked a little more once it's in the pot. You just want to have it nice and cooked to the point that it isn't raw and floppy. For me, my rhythm ended up being about 2 potatoes peeled and diced to about every flip of the bacon. Once the bacon's done, remove it to the paper towel rack, and most importantly, before you put on the new strips of bacon, drain as much of that rendered bacon fat as possible into the ramekins. You're going to need some of that later on, and the rest is an excellent cooking grease for stuff that's fine at low temperatures. Now, put on some more strips and keep peeling those taters. You should run out of taters before you run out of bacon, but not by much. Once all the bacon is cooked and draining, now would be a good time to do your first water change on those taters. Carefully dump out the water in your mixing bowls and then give them a bit of a rinse before completely refilling the bowls. Set those aside, clean off your cutting board, and now it's time to chop your veggies. Also, do yourself a favor and at least rinse the starch off your knife, because otherwise you're gonna have a bad time in general. By the way, no more first-person footage, as it seems that while GoPros can easily handle filming Kyle wrecking his $10,000 dirt bike that he paid for with what was supposed to be his tuition money for his first semester at Frat Life State, they cannot withstand the heat coming from a poorly made electric stovetop. So wash off those stalks of celery and peel the onions. Go ahead and chop up those stalks of celery into bits that are less than an inch long, and if you want, you can go smaller than that and even chop them down the middle too. The aim here is to get them into small enough pieces so that they'll cook at a reasonable span of time. Now, toss them into that third bowl you set aside and start chopping the onion here. The onion doesn't have to be super finely done or even remotely consistent, since it's all gonna get pulverized in the end anyway. Now add the onion to that bowl and peel your garlic. I like the apply violence to the side of the knife method, but if you're feeling iffy about it, do it however you like. set the garlic cloves aside from the other chopped veggies since you're gonna have them go in much later than everything else or they'll burn and start a domino effect that results in your ultimate ruination. Just trust me on that one, okay? It's time to cook. So first order of business is to get rid of that other frying pan if you used it and have your high-walled saucepan at the ready. You're gonna wanna take like half a cup of all that rendered bacon fat, pour about half of that in, and then dump in all your not potato and garlic plant things into the sauce pot. Then pour the rest over the top and give them a good mix with that spatula or wooden spoon. Partially cover this sucker and then get your meats cutting board out for the bacon, which should be as drained as it's gonna be by now. While the veggies are starting to get going, roughly chop your bacon into smallish bits. Again, it doesn't have to be super fancy and consistent, just small enough to where it'll all easily mix in. Some of this bacon is gonna be more done than the rest, and that's cool. It'd actually be pretty impressive if you managed to cook that much bacon all at once with all of it coming out exactly the same. Once the bacon's all nice and chopped up, it's time to add it to the veggie mix. Dump it all in there and give it another good mix in before letting it go for another few minutes. Now would be a time to get your big stock pot ready if you haven't gotten it out yet. Once everything's gotten to know each other in the saucepan, add in the garlic that you prepped however you want to prep it and give it another good mixing before letting it go for just a little bit so that it gets incorporated but doesn't burn. Alright, now what you're gonna do is carefully dump all your bacon and veggies into that big stock pot. Give your taters one last rinse and draining before adding them in, and then finally start adding in the broth until all that stuff is just submerged by the chicken juice. Once it's all in the pot, carefully give it a good mix, cover the pot, and then set it to medium-high until you get it to a boil, and then put 1 hour on the timer. This might take a while to come to a boil as you've got a lot of stuff in a really big pot and your burners can only do so much. Once it's all coming to a rolling boil, reduce the heat and move the pot lid so that it's only partially covering the soup and then just let the timer go until it hits zero. By the way, did you remember to leave the butter out so it's softened and easier to melt? It's cool, you can just zap that sucker in the microwave for like 20 seconds and it'll be fine. Okay, timer's gone off, but don't kill the heat just yet. The timer was there just to make sure that the taters got the minimum amount of cook time they needed before everything gets tossed in. It could probably go for another hour or two if you really wanted them to. What we're gonna do now is chuck that pound of butter into the saucepan and let it melt. Keep your spatula or wooden spoon handy. All right, the next bit is gonna be a bit tricky, but I know you can do it. What we're gonna do is reduce the heat, grab your flour sifter, and then just scoop some flour out of a bag with the sifter and just sift it right onto the melted butter, mixing with your other hand until it gets all incorporated. Don't sift in any more until you see that all of the bit that you sifted in is evenly mixed, and then add just a little bit more. You're gonna keep doing this until all the liquid butter is incorporated into a wonderful heart-stopping sludge. Now comes the extra tricky part. Open up your half and half and your heavy whipping cream, and we're gonna do a 1-to-1 ratio here. But if you want your soup to be dummy thick, use more heavy whipping cream. And if you want your soup to be an actual liquid, use more half and half. Now, carefully, while continuously stirring, add a bit of one liquid into the roux, give it some time to incorporate while you stir, and then add in a bit of the other liquid. Repeat this until you're out of both half and half and heavy whipping cream. Also, do not stir too vigorously like I did here or else you'll lose all the good stuff. Don't be like me, I am bad. Once it's all in and properly mixed, it'll be a real thick substance, but still a liquid. If you want, you can add some more pepper and oregano or parsley here, because this would be a good place to do it. Once it's all good to go, we get to the riskiest step of this whole ordeal. It's time to add that cream mix to the stewed taters. Part of the reason why we left the pot partially covered is because we wanted to boil down that bit and make some room for the cream. Now, carefully pour the cream mix into the big pot and then use the spatula to get everything mixed together. Go nice and slow here unless you want to look like big fat dummy pants Charl and lose an entire serving to your cooktop. Once it's mostly mixed, it's time to take out your immersion blender, dip her in there, and let it blend for like 10 seconds or so depending on how chunky you like your soup. Do not let the head of this immersion blender anywhere near the surface unless you want to get blasted with still boiling soup while ruining your entire kitchen. So you've done it. You've survived the ordeal of creating big soup. Big soup serves however many people you feel like it should serve and will keep for quite a while thanks to the sodium content of the broth and the bacon. Speaking of that, let's do some quick nutrition info. Calories, a lot. Total fat, yes. Protein, I don't know, there's meat in there, I guess. Carbs, potato. Total sodium content. Approximately as much or more as your typical cartoon fandom on Tumblr after the creator said something vaguely problematic.
So how about serving and reheating?
Well, to serve it, I'd suggest getting a big old ladle that'll allow you to fill the bowl in one scoop, as this stuff is so thick it tends to hang off the edges of whatever you're using to portion it and then drip everywhere, so the less you have to spoon it, the better. As for seasoning, you're only going to maybe need to add a little bit of salt because this thing is already inherently salty from the bacon and broth. As for heating, well, believe it or not, the stove is not the best option here, as the soup gets even thicker as it cools, and by the time it's heated through in a pot or something, whatever's on the bottom of the pot is gonna burn no matter how much you stir it. My advice for you is to toss it in the vibration box for a couple minutes, take it out and add some water until you can mix it, then throw it back in for another minute or so, stirring again once it's out. If you really want, you can try using extra broth instead of water, but this stuff is so thick, it's not like a little water is going to diminish the flavor, and come on man, this probably is already the most unhealthy thing I've ever done for a cooking segment. So, after you consume big soup, you might have some questions. Why are other soups so small? What do I do with all this extra soup? Will consuming this kill me? How do I get the bacon grease stains off my ceiling? Well, fret not. All of that will be revealed in time. This is definitely a once in a year kind of deal based on how rich it is, and this is also a recipe that's meant to be tweaked to your own taste. I've never really been sure when something goes from a recipe you found on the internet or in a book into your own recipe, but I went through many iterations of big soup. After trying the absolutely ultimate potato soup recipe, and while the core ingredients and basic methods are still similar, everything else is different. I don't know, I guess that's sort of a culinary existentialism thing.
All right, that's big soup.
Please do not try to consume it all at once or within a week or even a month because you'll probably die or something. Now that you've been warned, let's talk about what's coming up. January is going to be a little slow as I'll be taking a bit of a break for the first 2 weeks of the year, but then it'll be business as usual with Patreon voted I Divine Cybermancy being the next MSIM we cover, which you should look for around the third Saturday of January, and then we'll do a spooky game which I haven't decided on yet. Also, look for those pain miss cards in mid-January as I'm running the promotion over on Patreon for the whole month as this thing's non-denominational and I want everyone to get a chance to get their pledge in. Be sure to head over to patreon.com/charlatanwonder and make your yearly pledge so that you get an extra 2 months for free and you get a paid miss card, early access to videos, 4K cat clips, the ability to vote on major videos, and you get to help the good fight against sketchy sponsors. In the meantime, stay safe, stay indoors, wash your hands, wear your mask and practice social distancing when you have to go out, and enjoy this cat video.
Dude, we fed you like an hour ago. Jesus, this bowl is clean! And you're wobbly!
Oh, I almost got your wobbles. I'm coming for you! I'm coming for those wobbles. I'm crawling on like three. I'm gonna eat you, cat.
You cannot escape.